Call of Duty points are now in Infinite Warfare. If you want the best way to get free Call of Duty points, click the link down in the description, install the app, and start getting yourself some free Call of Duty points today. Yo, what is up, guys? It's the Goblin, and welcome back to another Call of Duty Infinite Warfare video. Today's video is going to be another episode of the Epic Weapons of Infinite Warfare, where I show you guys all of the epic variants in this game, and I talk about them, talk about what's good about them, what's negative about them, and ultimately whether or not they are worth going for and worth spending the 4,000 salvage, which is usually how you get these epic weapons. Hopefully you guys will enjoy this episode. I know you guys do like this series quite a bit, and I do appreciate all the support you guys have been giving me. 2,000 likes is going to be our goal today, so let's try to smash out 2,000 likes. And of course, if you want to get yourself some free Call of Duty points to help yourself get these epic weapons through supply drops, link for that is down in the description as always. So let's get right into this. Today's episode is going to be about the Titan Scout, which is the last epic LMG that I have to talk about. I've already talked about the Raw Liberty, as well as the other epic gun, which is the Mauler Mammoth, which was pretty cool. That gun is like a Gorgon, sort of a slow fire rate, high damage one. But this is the third epic LMG, and this is the Titan Scout. Let's throw it up on the screen right now and let's talk about it. So the first one that it comes with is Hacks, which is this weapon has a custom Trojan sight. And the second one is going to be Stability, which is, of course, reduced recoil stacked with foregrip, a pretty common variant. And then Hacks, of course, is, I think, only on this gun. There's no other version or no other variants in the game that use that Hacks trait. So what it does, basically, is we'll talk about it right now. What Hacks does is it gives you a custom Trojan sight. Now, the sight that you're seeing up on the screen right now, this is exactly the iron sights of this gun, which is kind of weird because this sort of red dot or sort of mini Elo sight with the green dot that I have, this comes built in on any version, on the base version of this gun. What the custom Trojan sight basically does is when I'm aiming down at these people and you'll see they light up yellow, it's essentially outlining people whoever are in my sight, which is what the original Trojan sight attachment does. Now, one good thing about this is I obviously like when it outlines the players. It really is helpful. It's like an upgraded pinpoint, and of course it comes free with the variant. But the bad thing is if you look when I'm aiming down sights with this gun, on the right side of the screen, there's a big fat thing, which is the custom Trojan sight sticking up that covers the whole right side of the screen when you're aiming down sights, and this does not come on the base version. This is only on this epic advanced Hacks Trojan sight, and this is kind of annoying because if you run just the normal Trojan sight, that will not be there. This does annoy some players because it's kind of hard to see on the right side of the screen. It does get you killed sometimes. I don't find that it's that big of a deal, and honestly, if it is that big of a deal, you can just run your own Trojan sight or run your own Elo sight. But by doing that, that would of course defeat the whole purpose of that trait. So that is up to personal preference. It's definitely got a positive, but it's also got a negative with that big fat Trojan sight covering the right side of the screen. The other one, which is Stability, of course, reduced recoil, is very helpful on this gun, especially because the Titan is the LMG that has a very fast fire rate. I don't think it's faster than the Mauler, but it's pretty fast fire rate, but it does kick up. It actually probably does have a faster fire rate than the Mauler. It's a really fast fire rate, but it also kicks up. Now, the recoil is pretty much straight vertical, but of course, having this Stability, which is essentially a built-in little mini grip, is very helpful, and that's something that makes this gun really good. Another thing that's awesome about this gun is, of course, how you have 100 bullets in it and it automatically energy regenerates. You don't really have to reload too often with this gun, which is awesome because that means you don't have to run Dexterity if you don't want to, which usually leaves room for people to run either Ghost and Recon or Ghost and Blast Shield, whatever you guys want in there. Now, that is this epic variant. This epic variant is a very good variant, and it definitely the Titan LMG is probably the weakest LMG, but it's still really good. I mean, the Raw LMG is one of the top guns in the game, as well as the Mauler, especially the Mauler Mammoth, is a very good variant. However, the one thing about this epic variant, while this epic variant is good, if we look at some of the other variants for the Titan, this gun has some really good variants, and I'll show them up on the screen right now. For example, this one is the Titan Slay Guide, or otherwise known as the Titan Reconnoiter, which basically most people got this for free if you logged on to the day where they were giving this away for free on the 12 Days of Winter event. variant, and this is the Titan Slay Guide. It has two things. It's a rare variant. The legendary variant of this gun is not very good, but the epic variant, of course, the Titan Scout is good, and the rare variant here is good as well. If you look at this one, this rare variant is probably one of the best rare variants in the game. I'll show it up on the screen right now. Titan Slay Guide, which is also called the Titan Reconnoiter, which you can actually just buy from the Quartermaster if you guys missed out on those 12 Days of Winter events. But this comes with Sensor, which what Sensor is essentially when you hit an enemy and they run away, or even as soon as you tag an enemy with a bullet, they are tagged up on the minimap. It's exactly the same as Recon Pro for Modern Warfare 3, and that thing is so damn overpowered because a lot of time you'll shoot an enemy, they'll run away, and you'll be like, I don't know where they went. If they're dots on the minimap, you're going to know exactly where they went. And it also comes with Sharpshooter, which essentially increases your damage at range, I believe. So that is amazing for a rare variant. And even if I show the other rare variant up on the screen right now, which is the Titan Warden, and this is like the rare variant that's been in the game the whole time, ever since the release. This one has Jackpot, kills grant an additional 10% score, which is really awesome. Helps you level up fast, helps you get your streaks faster, all that sort of stuff. And it also comes with Haste, slightly increased movement speed. So there's some really good rare variants of this gun. And that's why, in my opinion, even though the Titan Scout is an awesome epic variant, I would say it's, in reality, it's not worth that 4,000 salvage, because for only 500 salvage, you could get something like the Titan Reconnoiter if you don't already have the Slay Guide, or you could get the Titan Warden, which both these variants are really, really good. And honestly, they compete with this thing. The best part about this epic variant is the built-in Trojan sight. Some people will like it, some people will hate it, but of course the reduced recoil is really awesome. However, the recoil on this gun, while there is quite a bit of recoil, it is very predictable, and that's why if you run one of these rare variants with which gives you help in other categories, you can control the recoil simply by rocking a grip or by learning to pull down on the thumbstick as you're shooting the gun, which is a bit more of an advanced tactic, but it's something that I talk a lot about with the Ripper and with a lot of the guns that have straight vertical recoil. I don't think that recoil is that big of a deal, because if you're aiming for the chest, what's the recoil going to do? Make you hit them in the head? That's even better, you know what I mean? However, the things that suck is guns that have recoil that will kick up to the right or up to the left, really unpredictable. When a gun has very, very predictable recoil, it is very easy to control, and that's what I definitely would say this Titan Scout has, or not just the Titan Scout, but any version of the Titan. And that's why I'd say this gun is probably not worth the 4,000 salvage unless you guys are really big fans of the Trojan Sight and you hate the recoil. Then I would say it's worth it, but in reality the rare variants of this gun are just so good that there's no point in working your way up to that epic when you can get those rare variants and play with those and do just as well, if not even better. Now, to talk more about the Titan in general as an LMG, the awesome thing about Infinite Warfare is it's the first game where LMGs really are super duper viable. They've always been usable in the past and pretty strong guns, but in this game, thanks to the combat rig setup, which I talk about this all day long, but I'll mention it quickly, it's Merc, and then I run the reactive armor, but man-at-arms as the trait is the most important thing, because it allows you to move at full maximum speed with an LMG, and due to this, LMGs are literally usable like assault rifles, like SMGs in Infinite Warfare, which is a first in Call of Duty, at least for me. I never used to be someone that when I pull out my tryhard pants, it would always be an assault rifle or an SMG. In this game, it actually can be an LMG, and the coolest thing about the LMGs and something about the Titan that's awesome with having those 100 bullets is essentially you don't need dexterity, and that opens up so many extra slots, because running dexterity or running extended mags always takes up slots on SMGs and on assault rifles. And with this gun, I find, and with these all these LMG setups, it's like I have so many slots available, I don't even know what to fill them up with, and that's why I can test out different perks. I think I was testing out in these gameplays, I was using momentum as a second perk, because I don't need scavenger, I have an LMG with hundreds and hundreds of rounds because I'm man at arms, and then I get to test out like recon as my first perk, which makes the mini map bigger. I can test out blast shield, I can use a bunch of different stuff because of the freedom that I get on these LMGs, essentially not having to worry about my ammo count, about reloading, about any of that stuff, which is awesome while still having a powerhouse weapon. And that's something I would definitely talk about and recommend for the class setup. Experiment a little bit with different perks, because LMGs are the time to do it. You don't need certain things to make your class setup even usable. On an LMG, once you have the gun and you have stock and quick draw, honestly, your gun is ready to go. Your LMG, you have stock, quick draw, man at arms, you're ready to go full speed, full steam ahead with the LMGs, and that's what's really awesome. Hope you guys did enjoy this video. Like I said, I'd really appreciate 2,000 likes it would be awesome to wake up tomorrow and see 2,000 likes on this video. So if you guys made it to the end of the video, comment LMG down in the comment section down below. And also be sure to drop a like on this thing and let's hit that goal of 2,000. That would of course be awesome. Thank you to everyone who's been supporting me. I've been working hard on these Infinite Warfare videos. Epic Weapons is a really awesome series. I love playing and testing out all the weapons. And I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Thanks for watching. Sub for Cookie and don't looky. And I'm out. Peace.